Hey everyone, so welcome back to our channel. So in that video, today we are delving into AI language models actually. So specifically, we'll be discussing with the two powerful AI models. The first one is GPT-3.5 and the another one is GPT-3.5-Turbo-16K actually. So between the two models, we'll be discussing with that token capacity and depth and complexity and use cases, speed, versus depth and technical progression, and so all those things we'll be discussing into that. So don't add too much. So let's deep dive into that. Let's start with the cornerstone of these models, like token capacity. So tokens are chunks of the text that these the model process actually. So GPT 3.5 Turbo can handle up to 4096 tokens, while GPT 3.5-Turbo-16K, it will be taking that 60,000 tokens actually. So with that expanded token limit of GPT 3.5-Turbo-16K, it can maintain a richer contextual and understanding that throughout that longer prompts and also responses. This make it excel its scenarios where depth and thoroughness it's a matter actually. So that's why 16k will it take for that turbo token actually. Beyond the token capacity, let's delve into the implication of conversational and depth and complexity. Let's go. GPT 3.5 Turbo is adapted at generating that coherent short responses, make it suitable for chatbots and a brief description. However, it might struggle, it retains the context in a lengthy back and forth actually. On other hand, so as you can see that 16K Turbo GPT 3.5 model extended token limit empowers to engage in more conversations actually. So its contains retention ability to shine through that, providing more satisfying that detailed interaction with that prompt user actually, obviously. Now let's explore that diverse of use cases these models and cater to. GPT 3.5 Turbo is your go-to when you need that concise output. Think of generation, short description or headlines or quick summaries. Meanwhile, GPT 3.5 Turbo with the 16K shines to text, requiring that comprehensive explanation along with that drafting lengthy articles and creating a detailed project documentation or even tutoring that complex subjects. And this model will be extended capacity proves that invaluable actually. So that's why it taking that 60k with a big model. Beyond their capabilities and performance factors or essential consideration, right? So let's dive into that. GPT 3.5 Turbo smaller token limit generally results are faster response time because of that token limit. This makes it ideal application for demanding that real-time interaction like a chatgpt that common website, right? So and the next part, GPT Turbo 16K might introduce slightly longer response and due to its expanded processing requirements, right? So your choice should go align with that balance between that response speed and depth of content actually. Let's take a moment to appreciate that technological advancement here actually. GPT 3.5 Turbo 16K represents that evaluation, that AI ability to understand, to generate a human-like it actually. So human-like text it actually. In that showcases how AI models bridging that gap between that language understanding and contextual reasoning. So this technological leap has been profound with that implication. So for industries like content creation and education and even research actually. Wrapping up the GPT 3.5 and 3.5 Turbo are monumental steps and AI language model, right? So let's see. In that, finally, if you choose that GPT 3.5 Turbo when you need that snappy outputs. At the same time, GPT 3.5 Turbo 16K when depth and context are paramount, actually. So you will get that in-depth details of the content, actually. Thank you for joining with me in that exploration of AI advanced language models. So if you really like that video, please subscribe my channel for more videos like this in the future, and see you on the next video. Bye. We hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and consider to subscribe our channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues who might find it useful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below, and we'll be happy to respond. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.